Hello, the goal of this video is to show you how to update a BMX X80 card such as the BMX AMI 0410 or the BMX AMO 0210 using the new firmware upgrade tool which is called Automation Device Maintenance. So for this example here, we're going to be using the version, we'll just bring that up for you. So here we can see the tool loading. So we're going to use version 3.1.147.0. We'll start with showing how to do it with the M340. And the connection type we're going to be using is the USB connection to the CPU. So here I have a very basic application. It's an empty application with the M340 and the AMO0210. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to build this application. I'm going to connect to the PLC, transfer that to the PLC. Once that's done, we're going to disconnect from the PLC. We no longer need this window. So now we're going to go into the EcoStruxure Automation Device Maintenance tool. This tool has a global folder for all your firmwares for the EcoStruxure Control Expert parts. So to know where your folder is located, we go to Settings and we go to Package Settings. In this case here, it shows that it's in C Users Public Documents General Electric Data Package. So if I bring that up here, okay, we see that I already have some files in there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go and add the two. I'm just going to show you here. I'm going to go and grab the two firmware I've downloaded and added to the database. So they should be, you see them there. All right, great. So now we don't need that anymore. Once you've added your firmware into the that folder, you can close that down. And we're gonna cancel that. First thing we're gonna do is add the M340 processor in here. So I'm gonna click Add, and I'm gonna type in the part number of my M340 processor, which in this case is a BMX P34-2020. I'm gonna grab it here, change that to a USB connection, click Add Device. Now I need to log in to the M340 first. So I'm gonna click on Set Credential, and I just need to set the firmware password, which is gonna be using the default password, which is FW download. Let me show you that here. So FW download. I'm gonna hit Save and Connect. This has turned green. Next step is to click on Extension. And now I'm gonna manually add the card that we want to update. So I'm gonna click Add. It's gonna ask for an extension and a slot. The extension is actually the rack number. So if we go back to the M340 project, let me bring that up here. We see that we are in rack 0, slot 3. So I'm gonna put that out. I'm gonna say, go fetch extension 0, which is a rack, and then slot 3. Click OK. If we expand that here, sorry about here, it's thinking. You see that it actually found my BMX AMO0210. What I need to do next is go to the update center, so that I want to grab a firmware. And then I can pick this one up here, which is the one I added to my my global folder here. So hit save. I check the box here, and then we go down here and say update. Now, floating device. So just a typical warning window here. We already have the version, but I'm gonna go ahead and say that, yeah, I want to update it anyway. just stop the PLC, because for any firmware upgrade, typically the PLC is going to be stopped. Keep that in mind if you're going to do an upgrade. And we see the progress bar. Done. And here we see that the firmware update was successful. Okay, now, so this is the first part where I show you where how to do this with an M340. What we're gonna do now, we're gonna go back out of here. So I'm just gonna just delete that PLC from the tool here. So now we're gonna do it with an M580. The only difference with the M580 is that there's some security involved. So in the project, what you'll need to make sure of is that the FTP services are enabled. So basically everything else is still disabled, but I had to manually enable the FTP, so that you need to do that as well to make sure that you can get a connection. So we're gonna build that up. And then we're going to connect. We're going to transfer that into the PLC so that we make sure that the FTP services are allowed. Sorry about that. And then we connect. We transfer into the M580. Run, disconnect. We don't need that window anymore. So I'm back here. So now, like before, we're gonna manually add our processor, which this time is a BME P58-4040. And I know that my version is that one, so it's the equal or lesser than 3.20. Again, we're gonna pick USB as the connection, add device, click the set credentials. Once again, FW download, let me show you that here. Save and connect. We're connected. We go to extension. Expand that. Sometimes it's going to find it by itself. So it did not. So we're going to manually add it. So remember, for the M580, we are actually trying to update a AMI 0410. So same thing, rack 0, slot 3. It found the AMI 0410. Let's grab update center, firmware. We pick the firmware we want to use, save that, and then select the module, click update. Confirm that we've verified that everything is in order, the version and everything. Click confirm. Again, it's dubbed the PLC. And we're done as well here. So firmware update was successful. So there you go. So I've shown you how to use the EcoStruxure automation device maintenance tool to update BMX in-rack cards, like the in this case, the AMI0410 or AMO0210, and using a USB connection. Hopefully that's gonna be good for you and help you on your firmware upgrades. Thank you.